Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we'll be discussing how to solve a problem which is related to final accounts, and we'll understand how to prepare a balance sheet along with the preparation of trading account and profit and loss account. So once you have already understood in the earlier videos that we can prepare a profit and loss account and a trading account, whereby the profit and loss account net profit will be transferred to balance sheet now. So we'll understand how to prepare the balance sheet in the illustration mentioned below. So when we speak about balance sheet is the end financial statement that is required to show the financial position of the company or any organization. Hence, when we speak about preparation of balance sheet, we ideally talk about the last statement being prepared. However, to prepare this specific balance sheet, we require supporting documents. That means supporting structures or supporting statements of accounts that can be termed as trading account as well as profit and loss account. So this specific trial balance gives you the details about it, and we'll further go ahead and check out how to prepare the trading account and profit and loss account for this specific illustration itself, and then transfer the net profit or net loss, whatever the case may be, in the balance sheet. But before doing that, let's go through the illustration and mark all the items which are a part of either trading account or profit and loss account, or the items that are supposed to reflect in the balance sheet. Let's go ahead and check the illustration out first. Cash in hand is a part of balance sheet, hence it will be termed as B. Motor car again is an asset, hence it will be termed as balance sheet item. Drawings again is a withdrawal of specific amount which is done by the owner itself, hence it will be subtracted from the capital amount, hence it forms a part of balance sheet liability side. Legal charges is a part of office and administrative expense, hence it will be a part of profit and loss account. Plant and machinery again is an asset that we have mentioned here, hence it will be a part of balance sheet asset side. The next that has been mentioned here is investment. Again, that is a part of balance sheet asset side, forming a part of current assets or long-term assets. The next that has been mentioned is opening stock, that forms a part of trading account, hence will be termed as T. Sales return is an item which is supposed to be subtracted from sales to find out the net sales that has happened in that financial year. Hence, we'll be terming it as a part of trading account. Salaries, as you know, is a part of office and administrative expense, hence it will be a profit and loss item. As discount allowed is an expense for any organization, hence it will be a part on the debit side of profit and loss account. The next item mentioned is carriage inward, which will be a part of trading account. The next item mentioned is wages, again a part of trading account. The item that has been mentioned next is postage, will be a part of debit side of the expense criteria, that means expense income, hence profit and loss. Debtors, again a part of sundry assets, hence it will be a part of balance sheet. Interest is an expense, hence a part of profit and loss account here. The next item mentioned is insurance premium, again a part of profit and loss account as it is an expense mentioned, that means you have paid out insurance premium. Purchases has been mentioned, which is a part of trading accounts. We have completed all the debit side items. Let's go on to the credit side and figure out which of them is a part of trading, profit and loss account or balance sheet. Capital, which is a part of balance sheet liability side. Discount received is an office and administrative income, hence it will be a part of profit and loss account credit side. Sales is a part of trading account credit side. Creditors, again being sundry creditors, will be a part of balance sheet liability side. Interest on investment is an income that you have received, however it is an income which is termed under profit and loss account, hence it will be a part of P&L. purchase return will be subtracted from the purchase item, hence it will be a part of trading account. The last item mentioned here is bills payable, which will be a part of liability side balance sheet, as it is a liability that has to be paid, hence a part of balance sheet. Closing stock, which has been mentioned in the adjustment, will have two effects. The first one will be a part of trading account credit side, and the second account will be mentioned in the balance sheet. Hence, it will be a part of asset side. So now that we've figured out all the items that are supposed to be a part of the illustration and which are a part of balance sheet, profit and loss account and trading account, let's go ahead and prepare each of this account in detail and figure out what is the net profit, net loss, or gross profit and gross loss, and whether the balance sheet is getting tallied or not. Let's figure out with the problem solving thing. Let's prepare the trading account first. Now that we've prepared the format for trading account, let's mention all the items that we have highlighted earlier in the illustration, which relates to trading account, including the adjustment, which is closing stock. So we'll be able to figure out whether we have a profit here, that means a gross profit, or a gross loss. So we'll first go ahead and mention all the debit side and credit side items, and then we'll figure out whether we have gross profit or gross loss. So whatever has been marked in the question as T, let's mention each of them here on the debit side and credit side as well. The amount besides or parallel to purchases has been written in the inner column, because we might know that there is certain purchase return that has been mentioned in the question. So we'll have to adjust it accordingly, and then we'll have to write down the net amount of purchases in the outer column. Hence, the amount has been mentioned in the inner column here. So now with this, all we have to do is find out the interim balance, because all the unnecessary items have been mentioned apart from closing stock. So we'll be first mentioning the closing stock, which has been mentioned in the adjustment. Make sure the second adjustment to that specific thing is mentioned in the balance sheet as well. So closing stock will be mentioned here, and then we'll be finding out the interim balance. So if you can see in the interim balance, whatever we found out, that the debit side is lower as compared to the credit side, which clearly states there is a profit here. Hence, we have earned the gross profit, which will be mentioned on the debit side as a balance between the credit and debit side. Hence, this specific gross profit will be added to the interim total, and that will match up the total of both trading side debit and trading side credit. Hence, we have earned gross profit will be the next point of profit and loss account. That means the starting point of profit and loss account. So let's figure out what the gross profit is. So now that we have figured out the gross profit here, let's prepare the profit and loss account and then see whether we have net profit or net loss here. We have prepared the specimen for profit and loss account. Now, whatever items which were mentioned as P, besides all the items which has been mentioned in the trial balance, will be noted down here. But we'll start with the gross profit first. We have mentioned the gross profit now. So let's go ahead and prepare the other items. That means mention down all the debit items of profit and loss account and the credit items of profit and loss account here. Now that we have mentioned all the items of both profit and loss account, that means debit side and credit side as well, let's figure out the interim balance, and then we'll go ahead and check whether we have net profit or net loss here. So as you can see that we have a net profit here, which is amounting to 116,500, which means we have debit side on the lower side and credit side on the higher side. Now that we have figured out the net profit here, let's prepare the total balance sheet or the balance sheet here, which will have a specification as described in the next sheet itself. Now, let's prepare the balance sheet and see whether we have all the items mentioned in the asset column as well as in the liabilities column. Unlike trading and profit and loss account, you don't have to mention debit and credit here, because balance sheet doesn't have debit and credit side. It has liabilities and asset side, which has been mentioned in the sheet shown below. Now, let's post all the items. But first, we'll post the two necessary items, that means the capital less drawings, and add profit and loss account, that means the reserves or probably the net profit that has been earned in the profit and loss statement. After which, we'll be looking forward for the closing accounts, that means the closing stock statement details mentioned in the adjustment criteria. Let's go ahead with that first. So the total of the capital account comes to 138,500. That means the capital amount itself 70,000 less drawings from it, and add the net profit. We have also mentioned reserves and surplus, because sometimes in the question reserves and surplus is a part, hence you have to add it to the capital balance. So the total of capital amount has been mentioned in the outer column here. Now let's post all the other items which are related to the balance sheet, liability side and asset side. So as you can see that we have mentioned down all the items which are related to balance sheet asset side and liability side. Hence, it should be tallying around here. So this is the closure of whenever we have to prepare a balance sheet. Further, when you go ahead with more illustrations on major adjustments, which we'll be studying in the next video, that means we'll be studying certain basic adjustments and then we'll be further studying onto how complete adjustment problems are supposed to be solved. That time we'll have more idea on how to solve basic adjustment balance sheet problems and complete adjustment balance sheet problems. So with this sum or with this illustration, I hope you have a lot of clarity on how to prepare a trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet, and clear out your doubts whether we are required to prepare all the items. The first part, rather making down or pointing it out as to which items will be a part of trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet. So segregation is the first part, that is the first process while preparing final statements, and then marking down the adjustments with two different effects will be the second part, which will help you in clearing out your doubts whether preparing balance sheet will be a flawless job or not. So I hope this illustration gave you a lot of information about preparation of balance sheet and how different it is from both the financial statements, that is trading account and profit and loss account. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and keep subscribing to Ikeda.